Microinverter and solar panel selection is often misunderstood by homeowners. This video will help explain the basics of selecting the best microinverter for your project. First, let's review the key advantage of microinverters, which is a distributed architecture where each solar panel operates independently from the rest. A system with the alternative centralized technology with a string inverter can suffer a large reduction in power with a small amount of shade, and a failure of the inverter will bring the entire system down. Enphase microinverters improve the performance, safety, intelligence, and resilience of solar. The IQ8 family of microinverters offers solutions for different solar panels and applications. How do you determine which microinverter model to pair with a given solar panel? Microinverters are available with different peak power capacities to accommodate the many different solar panels on the market. The best microinverter for a project will achieve the right balance of energy production and cost for the life of the system. The peak power of a microinverter is in AC, or alternating current watts, whereas the rated power of a solar panel is in DC, or direct current watts. The microinverter converts the DC power from the solar panel to AC power for the home. It's important to understand that the DC rated power of a solar panel does not reflect the power it will produce in real-world conditions. A solar panel's DC rated power is determined in a favorable and highly controlled laboratory setting known as standard test conditions, which consists of an intense flash of light on an artificially cooled solar panel. In the real world, the power output is relative to the intensity and angle of the sunlight, which varies greatly as the sun rises and moves across the sky, as well as with the seasons of the year. When the sun is strong, the panel will also get very warm, which reduces the potential power output. The panels will also get naturally slightly soiled, which will block some of the sunlight. Good solar design ensures that the full capacity of microinverters is utilized. It is worth noting that on limited occasions, all solar inverters, including string and microinverters, may reach their maximum output. Let's look at a few examples to illustrate how different solar panel and microinverter pairings will perform in real-world conditions. Here we have a pairing where the DC-rated power of the solar panel is the same as the AC peak power of the microinverter. This is considered a DC to AC ratio of 1:1. During the sunniest time of year, when a solar panel's power output peaks, the highest level is well below the maximum capacity of the microinverter. This scenario is not optimal, as the microinverter's full potential is not being utilized. With this pairing, the rated power of the solar panel is much higher than the peak power rating of the microinverter. This is a 1.6:1 ratio. With such a high ratio, the microinverter reaches its maximum power output frequently and throughout most of the year. A significant portion of the potential energy production is not captured. This, too, is a poor pairing choice. Finally, we have an optimal pairing for the climate and other site characteristics like panel orientation and tilt. The DC to AC ratio is 1.3:1, and during the sunniest time of the year, the inverter periodically reaches its peak power and maximum potential. These periods of inverter saturation are represented in the Enphase app as a flat portion of the bell curve of a day's energy production. A system with an optimal pairing will experience periods of saturation during high production months, typically early summer. While the rest of the year, the peak power of the microinverter is not usually reached, and there is little or no uncaptured energy. Computer modeling of this pairing tells us that less than 1% of potential energy production is not captured on an annual basis. How can we be sure that we've selected the optimal pairing of microinverter and solar panel? A simple way is to compare the value of the uncaptured energy to the cost difference of using a higher-powered microinverter. Consider a scenario with a 9-kilowatt system with a 1.3:1 DC to AC ratio, located in Dallas, Texas, with clean new solar panels facing south at an ideal 25-degree tilt. Conditions don't get much better than this. The estimated uncaptured energy is 139 kilowatt-hours per year, and the average cost of energy is 17 cents per kilowatt-hour, The total value of the uncaptured energy is $23.63 in the first year. Now let's calculate the cost of using a higher-powered microinverter to see if it would be worth it in order to capture 100% of the potential energy production. At a price difference of $25 for each micro, the total additional cost is $525. Is it worth spending an additional $525 on higher-power micros to capture only about $24 worth of additional energy per year? Dividing $525 by 2363 tells us that it would take about 22 years to pay for itself. It's worth noting that over time, the amount of uncaptured energy will decrease as the solar panels gradually degrade with age and put out less power. So the payback period will actually be longer than this simple payback calculation suggests. In this scenario, we've determined that the higher cost of using a higher power microinverter is not justified. The higher ratio of 1.3 to 1 is the better value. Most PV systems won't have such ideal conditions. If your system has a less optimal orientation or is in a location with less intense sunshine, you could choose to go with an even higher ratio. Selecting the best microinverter for a given location is easy to do. Enphase has a tech brief available for solar professionals or inquisitive homeowners on the topic of pairing microinverters and solar panels. A link to the tech brief is in the video notes or in the documentation center of the Enphase website. Taking the time to select the optimal microinverter for your project will ensure you build a high-performance system with the best possible return on investment.